Hey guys, so today I'm going to be talking about packing to go to Japan. As you may know, I am going for 5 months to study at Ritsumei Kan University in Kyoto, Japan. So today I'm going to be talking about what I'm bringing and some of my favorite packing tips. So to start off with, I'm going to be bringing this ginormous 50-pound suitcase. This is going to be what's carrying a bulk of all my clothing. I use some of my textbooks and random things that I think I will be needing. I will also be bringing this is my carry-on because it's a nice overnight bag. So I want to go to Korea and travel around in Japan, and I don't want to like have to bring this if I'm going to be staying more than a couple nights. So that is going to be like my weekend bag and stuff like that. And then as my personal item, I am bringing this backpack. Just gonna carry some my books, my laptop, my Kindle, which somehow made its way out of there, and stuff like that. And in addition to these bags, which are what I'm actually gonna be bringing, I'm also in my suitcase. I'm bringing this collapsible duffel bag. It gets about yay big, and this is gonna be my second carry-on for when I get when I return back to the U.S. The reason why I'm doing this is because since I'm bringing this stuff to the brim, I want to have room for, like, souvenirs and such in, like, all of the clothing that I plan on buying in Japan. So, that's going to be kind of like my overflow, because I do think I'm allowed 2 50-pound bags, but I'm only bringing one because I really don't want to have to carry all of that. Around Kyoto trying to find my hostel and then later to find my dorm, and it's just not fun. So these are the 3 bags I'm bringing to Japan, and then I will be leaving with 4. Next, one thing I noticed when I was looking at packing tips and what to bring if you travel to Japan or other countries for extended amounts of time, they always tell you to bring like neutral colors and stuff you can mix really well. Well, I think that's great and all. I don't think that's really applicable to Japan. The reason why I say this is Japanese fashion is very eccentric compared to maybe the fashion in my hometown, where our go-to uniform basically is jeans, black t-shirt, and like Converse or another type of sneaker. Very laid back style. Japan is more, it's a lot less casual, and I feel like you can get away with a lot more in terms of style. You can wear more outlandish things. So I'm bringing mostly statement pieces, because also why waste room in my suitcase with some like plain neutral color t-shirts that I can buy in Japan for $5? I'd much rather bring stuff that I can't find in Japan that I really, really like, and bring that with me instead, and just buy boring clothes there. And I do plan on going shopping a lot. That's like one of the things I want to do, because I love, 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 love Japanese fashion. One thing to consider when packing: your size. As most of you know, if you're going to Japan, Japan has They tend to be a lot smaller than most Western countries, both in stature and in weight. So, if you're, for like example, guys, if you're really tall or if you have big feet, I would plan on bringing a lot more clothes and buying a lot less, because you don't know if you're going to find your size. I don't know the men's sizes and I don't know the men's average. I'm sorry. What I recommend is you look up your size and compare it to the average sizes in Japan in measurements. And the average size is usually about a medium in Japan, so you'll probably be able to find a little bigger and a little smaller. For women, I can give you a little more input. I am overweight. I've done that in a lot of, I made another video about that, and I wear size L in Japan comfortably. So I have no problems finding my size in most shops. So I don't really have to worry about that. The one thing I am bringing a lot of is shorts and pants, because I do have wide hips, and I found that finding jeans and stuff that fit me in Japan was very difficult. But it's a learning experience. And also, if you are plus size, do not fear. There are plus size people in Japan too, and they don't walk around naked. They do have plus size shops. They just are a little less common, and you may have to settle for shopping online for some things. But don't fear. If you really are a big fan of Japanese fashion and you are plus size, you will be able to find some Japanese fashion. Don't worry about it. That being said, for girls, if you are larger than like a large C cup and above, I would say bring your own bras. It's Japanese bras tend to run smaller, not only because Japanese women are smaller, they're skinnier, so boobs tend to be smaller as well. Also, if you have a large band size, then I would suggest bringing your own bras. I'm personally bringing my own bras because I don't know if I will find my size, and I'd rather not find out the hard way that they don't have my size for a reasonable price. Toiletries. Since Japan is a developed country, you will be able to find pretty much everything you use in your own country really easily. I wouldn't pack large amounts of like shampoo, conditioner, unless you're like really picky, but I mean, that's going to take up some valuable pounds in your suitcase that you can be using for stuff that you really need, like textbooks. And you don't want to get those overcharge fees. I don't remember what they're called, but so I recommend bringing minimal toiletries, just enough to get you by for the first week or two. That way you can find everything and just shop there, because it'll be cheaper there. You don't have to worry. You'll have more room in your suitcase. It's just better. For girls, one thing I recommend is if you use tampons, bring them. They are not as common in Japan, and because they're not as common, they're a lot more expensive. What I do is I bring like a big old Costco box, and then I like stick fragile and breakable items in there, because I mean, they'll work as padding, and so they won't get broken, and they weigh like next to nothing, so it's not going to take up any of your valuable weight. It's just going to take up some space, but it's definitely worth it. They're very expensive. I don't recommend it. Another thing that isn't as common in Japan is stick deodorant. Japanese people seem to use spray deodorant a lot more than stick deodorant, so if you're a big fan of stick deodorant and you feel really icky without wearing it like I do, I have to wear regular stick deodorant or else I will get grossed out, bring it. You are able to find it, it's just not as common. So because it's not as common, it's a lot more expensive. So cheaper to bring it, it's just better that way. Airplane travel tip. Wear your biggest, bulkiest clothing on the plane. Now, if your biggest, bulkiest clothing includes a giant pair of stilettos, don't do it. You're going to be standing and walking, sometimes running. Heels are not meant for airports. I mean, if they're small wedges, then that's fine. That's what I'm going to be wearing, like these wedged booty things, because they're heavy and they're bulky, and I don't want to have them take up room in my suitcase. But no stilettos. Just no. But wearing your winter jacket, because not only is it really warm and in safe space in your bag, but then you can use that as a blanket instead of like the icky airplane blankets, and you can bunch it up and use it as a pillow. Like, this is the one I'm bringing, so you can like snuggle up as a blanket or like fold it up, and then you've got a pillow. So it's a really good idea to just bring these on the plane, because I mean, it's gonna take a lot of room in your suitcase. Might as well just wear it. Jeans better on the plane and stuff like that. So those are all my travel/packing tips. I'm leaving in, like, exactly 1 week.
Ah!
I leave next Friday at 6 in the morning. So scary. But I cannot wait to get there and film some awesome footage at all these awesome places and show you awesome things. And I know I'm saying awesome a lot, but I can't think of another adjective right now, so just bear with me. So I will see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.